which is like a skeleton for all these prayers. And it is used in Weinberg's music. He was probably inspired. He probably uses it in instrumental music as well as in his songs. I will try to just gently sing to you a slightly beautified version of this scale. It's a combination of major and minor. And to me, it kind of encapsulates what does it mean to be Jewish. So this combination of bittersweet, grief and joy, and sadness and hope, all mixed together. Just how we finished in major with some hope. And this song cycle is exactly that. It starts with a very carefree tune, then it goes into a few domestic situations. So a bread comes out of the oven and it's eaten very quickly and oh, it's gone. The second song is a lullaby sung by a mother to a child. And she's asking the nightingale and the wind to be quiet because her treasure is about to fall asleep. The third song is a young boy wanting to be a hunter. He wants to go into the woods and kill a big bear. And he finds a broom for a weapon. He tries to lift the broom turns over, and he hits his nose. There is no way he wants to be a hunter anymore. The next song is about a young tree growing on top of the hill, and the tree does not want to go to sleep, and the moon and the stars beg him, please fall asleep, but the tree does not want to listen, does not want to close the eyes, and then suddenly it sleeps. Just like that. The last song is a letter written by an orphan to her mother. She's asking the wind to take the letter to her mother. There is no food, there is no drink, and my bed is so rough. And they only want to hear my tears, but I have none left. Mother, hear me. And it finishes with exactly the same tune as it started, but slightly differently. It's scared. It's unsure of the future. And yet, in the last few chords, it becomes a major, gives us hope.
Thank you. нашу совесть.